Welcome back to Truck Spotting Great Lakes. We are 218 miles on into 94 in Montana, which we're almost out of Montana. We're just about to climb into North Dakota. Pretty cool little area around here. Wherever you are. out, we'd like to have, you know, clothes on your back, food in your belly, and cars to drive, and houses to live in, and, well, you name it, just come after the back of a truck. Starts out in a factory, pieces come to the factory, comes off the truck to build your whatever, toaster or car or whatever, and then it gets put back on the truck and it gets shipped somewhere else to be rebuilt even more, and then put back on the truck and then shipped somewhere else, maybe to the nearest Walmart or nearest store or gas station or whatever. Drive down the road, and to anybody else, I'm talking to myself, but really here I am talking to you guys. And if you haven't noticed, if you have seen other videos of me talking, I don't stop. I don't stop talking. This is a very lonely job. I have a dog in here, and she'll bark, but I don't understand what she's saying. If I'm not talking to you folks, you good folks, then I'm talking on the phone. And if I'm not talking on the phone, I'm in my head driving down the highway. Because most of the time, you see what you see here. It's nothing out here. It may be beautiful in its own little way, but you got lots and lots of time to think about things. Then you come across little things like what you just saw back there, two little crosses on sticks. And if you don't, and most people know what that means, and if you don't know what that means, means that someone had an accident there and two people had passed away right there on the side of the road. That's what that means. And you see that here and there. And in my business of doing this for a long time, you see a lot of it. Because roads are pretty dangerous. Out here, anything can happen. You may not pay attention to the road, and all of a sudden your wheels come off the road and onto the gravel, and you're doing, say, 70 miles an hour, or in our case, that would be like 115 kilometers, opposed to 120. Hitting that gravel, doing that kind of speed, it doesn't take long before you lose control, or your tire blows, or whatever, or someone falls asleep behind the wheel and smacks into you, or, you know, there's so many different ways, or it could be a drunk driver, or it could be someone running from the cops, and you know, whatever. We've all seen what you can see on the TV and what TV and the internet shows you in the mail. Highways are not safe. They're like everything else. Anything can happen. So what I'm pretty much trying to say. Because you don't really know when your last day is. No one knows that, right? And if you do, if someone came up and said, "I know exactly when your last day, when you're gonna die, blah blah blah," right down to the second, in the minute, and the second, would you want to know? I don't want to know that. But you don't know, you know, you wake up in the morning, if you wake up, but if you wake up in the morning, I'm a morning person. I wake up in the morning and I feel great, I'm a happy person, happy, joy. But you don't know when your last day is, why, you know, I don't know what's going to happen today. I assume, which everybody knows what it's assumed, you make an ass out of me and you. But I assume that I'm going to do my job like I do always. And I'm going to get to the other side. I'm going to park my truck at the truck stop. And I'm going to climb into bed. And I'm going to do it all over again the next day. You never know best day you can possibly get. That's what I do. So I try to make people laugh. I try to do that. If that means making fun of my own self doing it, then so be it. If I can get that person to laugh, then that makes me feel good. I think laughter is very important for your mental state and everything else. Thank you. allowed to bring peanuts and anything that had peanuts in it to school. If someone was allergic to peanuts, they wouldn't have it. We have this big old Western Star coming up. Oversized. He's flying. Check out the little mirrors he's got hanging out on the side of the truck. Look at that. Just because of the load so you can see. You can see where you are. That's the proper thing. I'm kind of curious on what that is. Whatever it is, it's obviously big. Anyway, back to the peanut butter and jelly sandwich. So, grab the peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Marked up. And I said to this kid, I'm going to call him a kid because he is a kid towards me. So I said, Jesus, I haven't had a peanut butter and jelly sandwich in a long time. He goes, really? I said, yeah, I haven't had one since I was in school. I said, I can't tell you how long that is, but then you'll have a bit of a rough idea of how old I am. He goes, well, I don't really care if you say it. I won't judge you. I'm like, alright. I says, I think the last time I had a peanut butter and jelly sandwich was probably about 35 years ago. And he goes, damn! Obviously, he can't be no more than 22 years old, maybe. Yeah. Hadn't had a peanut butter and jelly sandwich since probably as long as his parents were alive. Maybe a little longer. They're probably my age. Old. I'm not that old, though. I'll be 48 this year. Still, 48 is 48. Two more years, I'll be 50, so I guess I am that bloody old now. But 50 is really not that old, is it?